Hey everybody, welcome to the JBL and Cole show, and we're in Toronto, Canada.
Hey,
and
we Toronto.
Have our resident Canadian with us, Renee Young.
I got my tetanus shot, so I'll be fine up here in Canada.
I think they have to put you in like quarantine or something just to make sure that it's okay, but this is the land of my people. We're in Toronto.
You have quarantine the entire country?
No, you go.
We'll get on. You know, we don't have malaria issues here either, do we?
I don't think so. I think we'll probably be okay. Well, there's other issues.
Let's start our tour, well, Renee's tour, really, so to speak, at the Rogers Centre, formerly Sky Dome, here in Toronto, where you, I understand, attended your first ever WWE event.
I did. Back in February 1999, they had Raw here, which aired actually on the 13th. It was my first time being at a WWE event. I went backstage, I met Stone Cold, I met China, Mankind. So like a little miniature version of me walking around.
So that was 12 years ago, so you were 5.
Yes, exactly. Thank you for that. And you were there, were you not?
Yes, I was there.
Kind of weird, right?
And now I was there as well.
We're all here together.
Yes, but nobody knows you.
Over 41,000 fans for that Raw, one of the biggest Raw crowds in history. Also in this building, WrestleMania 18. Of course, the main event, it was Hogan versus The Rock. It was the largest paid crowd ever in SkyDome history.
Broke the record set by WrestleMania 6 of the Ultimate Challenge, the Ultimate Warrior versus Hulk Hogan, the Ultimate Warrior's first world championship.
A lot of history right here at SkyDome. Now, we were talking about WrestleMania 18. Remember what happened the night after Hogan and Rock met here? Monday Night Raw, Hulk Hogan came out to the largest ovation in the history of Monday Night Raw. It was like a 20-minute ovation, still one of the longest segments in Raw history.
Every week I'm expecting to break that. I don't know, people don't see this because it's not on camera. When I walk out sometimes, I got WrestleMania when I walked out this past year, man, last year. When I walked out, the rain stopped. What kind of respect is that? From Mother Nature.
You're afraid you're going to slide.
That's true, isn't it?
I'm always nervous when you do that like two-step thing that you're going to wipe out. And one day it might happen and it will not be cool.
I tell them all the time, that is going to be the greatest night in history. So where are we going next on this tour?
Well, we've got the CN Tower here. We can go, I don't know if we're going to get up to the top of that thing, but we can go scope out there.
Well, let's pull some strings and go.
Let's do that. And otherwise, we're going to go off to the fence.
You just stepped on a grenade.
Yeah, stepped on my phone.
Is that over there? Let's go.
Yeah, let's get out of here. Give me my phone, brother.
This place would be great if there weren't so many freaking Canadians.
So Renee's tour of Toronto has brought us across the street, well, from the parking lot that we were in for the ride.
So you know what? Why don't we let Renee tell us what this is all about? Hey?
Okay. First of all, it's very hard to get rid of my Canadian accent. So this is the CN Tower. It is the tallest freestanding structure.
I'm proud of my Texas accent. I don't know why you're not proud of your Canadian accent. Apparently, you don't like anybody from Canada. I don't know.
Whoa.
So you're the one that said it. You're the one that's abandoning your country. You're abandoning your country. I say y'all, and I'm proud of it.
I started saying y'all because I travel.
And you're trying to learn how not to speak Canadian.
Yeah, you live in Bermuda now. What are you talking about? You're not a Texan anymore.
But I live in South Bermuda.
What you're saying is you're not a New Yorker anymore because you live
in Texas. That's right. You don't live anywhere.
Yeah, but I stayed in the United States. I didn't abandon my country.
We used to go to Bermuda or from Canada to the U.S.
Abandon your country.
Oh, absolutely not. I still play full federal income tax.
Anyway, tell us about this place.
So the CN Tower, you can go all the way up there. There's a glass floor when you get up there, which is terrifying to look down on. And they now, in the last like couple of years, they started this thing where you can get strapped into a harness and you can walk around outside the top of the CN Tower.
Oh, that was cool.
Horrifying. And there's a restaurant in there that rotates. So you can go to dinner and it gives you a whole panoramic of the whole city. It's pretty
cool. But all you can see is Toronto, right?
Yeah, you can maybe see part of Buffalo if you really love card.
Wow, great place,
no,
Toronto
Buffalo.
And Buffalo.
Wonderful.
Where are we going next?
Great. We're going to go up to the Score, which is where I really got started my career, and now I'm here.
So they're responsible for all this?
Sure are.
Yeah, I'm going to punch somebody.
The World Tour is in Toronto, we get that, but we're actually in Cincinnati, getting ready for SmackDown.
Back at the good old US of A, out of
what summer for Bizarro Land.
So how did you just like fall asleep and forget that we actually got an airplane and
the 18th kind of falls asleep waking somebody else.
I was trying to pull it out for Toronto. I thought that we could do the whole like through television, no one's gonna notice. You guys just throw me under the bus like that. No one would have known.
See, we're getting ready to force out the doors here.
Yeah. We don't deceive our viewers.
The other thing, I certainly tried.
I think maybe one time we might have to do a little tour with Renee and Summer Rae, because it's a very interesting trip with those two. What a long, strange trip it's been.
Sure has.
After hours, they both figured out how to spell it.
Yeah. In Scrabble.
Yeah.
They were spotted to see in the sea.
Very.
They were out of the rat.
We'll see you next week. Thanks for coming.
What?